Hi, welcome to the third episode of my Fiber podcast. My name is Audrey, and I realized that last time I completely forgot to introduce myself. So, my name is Audrey, and this is a podcast about weaving, knitting, spinning, a little bit of dyeing, and if I ever learn how to use my sewing machine, there will be that too. You could see my cat. He escaped the frame. No, come back, kitty. I need you for the views. No, no, he doesn't want to. He likes to be by the pillow, so. So, it's gonna be a little bit less packed episode. Because like I said, I didn't have as much time as I usually have in the past couple of weeks. So, yeah, not as much finished things as the past two times, but I did start quite a lot of things, so I hope it's still gonna be nice. And I'm totally getting the sun being weird. Oh, that's better. Yeah, change of sets. You can totally see my stash that I tried to organize, and it lasted 2 weeks, and it's gonna stay a mess. I give up. So yeah, enough rambling. Let's jump right into weaving. I finished the scarf. I believe I only showed you the warp of it, but it's done. It is done now, and it turned out really nice. All the colors were really good woven. I found it really interesting how an hand-dyed yarn will look knitted or woven. Most of the time I do prefer woven. Yeah, but yeah, look at it. So this is Fly by Hedgehog Fibers, and this is Sea Spray by Knit Cosmic Strings that I already showed you because it's in my fade. And yeah, so this is how it looks woven. And I'm going to show it to you later, but let me quickly grab my fade to show you how it looks knitted. Yeah, this is it here. So it's very drapey, very soft. I have the little fringe in the end, and the white and the green and the gray, sorry, the white and the gray are just a Knit Picks palette. And yeah, I like it. I tried to take pictures of it, and it's complicated, but I wish I didn't have that sun. I love that sun. I'm very happy because I can finally film, but it's like in the morning, it goes straight into my room. So yeah, I hope it's not too contrasty. But yeah, woven scarf, it's long enough to do one warp, which is usually what I do when I want something lighter, more for the looks, which is the idea of the scarf. So yeah, like it. I now have to make a couple of pouches, zipped pouches and bags, and I started the first one. Let me show you. This is going to be a teeny tiny pouch. And so far it's looking like this. So I went for like more organic shapes. Yeah. So this is a Woolen Boon color. Woolen Boon Bedazzle. Woolen Boon is one of my favorite dyers. I would move to the US for her, but then I won't because but anyway. Woolen Boon again, Fly by Hedgehog Fibers, because I have quite a lot left, which is good. And this is a mini skein by Made by Black Elephant. The perfect Made by Black Elephant too. And this is Enchanted Forest, and it's super pretty. Yeah, I decided to flip the camera. So the focus is a little bit better, but maybe the quality isn't because now it's the front camera. I'll see. I'll see how it goes. So yeah, I've reached the middle of it and now I'm going to do the other side of the pouch because I'm going to close it like this. And yeah, I have a zipper somewhere. Maybe I can show it to you. This is the zipper that's going to go to close it. It's 12 centimeter, I believe. It's light blue. And I have a few zippers of different width in very nice colors, pastel colors. So yeah, I have a couple of bags to make in. I hope to get this one done today or tomorrow. I'm gonna make them, weave them, and then I'm gonna go on a zipping sewing machine spree all together. Yeah, this is it for weaving. Yeah, that's where we are. So now on to spinning. And I received my Turkish spindle. And look, it's big. I didn't expect it to be that big. Yes, I'm the girl that doesn't look the size on Etsy. Completely ignore that. So yeah, and I managed to make a really pretty cob. Turtle. I'm gonna call it turtle. Yes. So this is the 100% alpaca that I already showed you, the one I spun thick and thin. And so I'm going to spin all of this. Going to take a long time. And I'm going to chain ply it. Even though it looks really pretty as a single, I want to chain ply it because I like pile of fluff. I just got out because you're making a mess. This is all the spinning. I've been waiting for that Turkish spindle and I really like it. I really do. It's beautiful. It spins wonderfully. It's very light, although it's big. And it has a hook, which is I believe quite unusual for a Turkish spindle, but it's so convenient and it spins really nicely. Yeah. It really does. I really like it. I enjoy spinning on it. It takes more time to nicely wrap the single around the arms, but it's worth it. It's completely useless because it's going to come off and I'm going to wind it as a skein. But at least while I'm spinning it, since it's taking a long time, yeah, at least I can enjoy the look of it. I'm sorry, I'm a bit all over the place today. I guess I'm a bit confused as to what I did show you, what I didn't show you, because it's been more than a week, so I'm a bit all over the place. But yeah, this is all the spinning I've done. I did dye one skein of yarn, but it's for my fiber share partner, so it's secret. It's secret. I really like the color I got. I also spun a little thing for her. I almost have everything. Like, when did they send the emails? On Sunday? And it's Wednesday? And I almost have everything for her. I mean, crazy. I'm so excited. It's my first time doing fiber share. So I guess I'm a little bit overdoing it and overwhelmed, but I really hope she will enjoy the little, looking at the little box because I already have the box and everything. It's going to Australia. I'm going to have to go through Australian customs. Should be fine. I'm not gonna put any peanut butter or other extra dangerous substance. But yeah. So I did dive, I have nothing to show you. So I guess we can jump right into knitting. Knitting, that's how it's called. I'm messing my crafts up. knitting. I am melting, fading into my last color on my Find Your Fade shawl. So I have the two bowls attached, so I'm going to try not to make a mess and not to lose any stitches. Like I suspected, it's much smaller than it should be, but it's fine because I'm just going to block it and that's going to open the lace and make it a little bit bigger. So, last time I showed you my fade, I believe I was there and I was melting Orchid by Knit Cosmic String with Sea Spray by Knit Cosmic String, and I like how for the first part of my fade at least it's quite a dramatic change of color, but they don't stripe. You can't see stripes, so they do fade into each other, but the colors are rather different. So I did Sea Spray and I faded it into, again, Bedazzle. I should have looked. I'm gonna write everything in the show notes anyway. By the Woolen Boons, lovely pastel blue. This one is beautiful. And again, it faded really nicely. And then here's the crazy part, because I'm going into Coral, which is a kindred red color, whose name I forgot as well. Kindred red, coral, pink, yellow and orange color. And they did stripe a little bit, but since there are two light colors, it's fine. It's just fine. And I am now going into my last color. I'm doing the melting. It's gonna stripe as well a little bit. But yes, I'm almost done. I hope I'm going to finish it this week. I definitely am. So, this is the Kindred Red. What's his name? And this is again Woolen Boons. This is my last color. It's Woolen Boons Space Cowboy. And it has as well the coral, the exact same coral as the Kindred Red, but it kind of goes back to the purple of the beginning of my fades. So, yeah. Very happy with my color choices. It looks really nice. I think I'm going to enjoy it finished a lot. It's getting long, but I'm not giving up on it, because I know if I space the time I work on it and I do little by little, I'm gonna get a little bit bored of it maybe, because the rows are so long during the end. So that's why I'm not giving up on it. I want to finish it as fast as possible so I can truly enjoy the finished product without getting it kind of forgotten in some place. I have also cast on those transitions. Jeez, I could make an effort. Anyway, I have cast on the lacy scarf that I want to do for my mom for spring. So like I said, I'm going to make a border with, this is Cascade Heritage. I believe the color is 5655. With these Ivy by Knit Cosmic Strings being the main body. So I've cast it on with the Cascade. And the pattern calls for 3.5mm needles, but I really wanted it to be super lacy, super drapey, super, super, ringy, super, everything. So I'm using 5 millimeter. I know that's a big jump, but I am a tight knitter. And I just did the board, the garter border, and one lace repeat. My nails are orange, I'm sorry, hair dyeing. But yeah, I just did one lace repeat. So far it doesn't look like anything, but these are 40 centimeters needle eddies. It's not the best, but my needle collection is a bit, it's a mess. I really should have just bought a set because I don't have the sizes, I don't have the right length of cables, it's messy. But yeah, it's working, and I do have a meter cable on fives as well, but I figured that would have annoyed me. So the 40 centimeters are okay. They're okay. I hope it's gonna turn out nice. I think I'm going to work a little bit on it today to see kind of how it looks and if I like it. Because I can't wait to see if I like it. And yes. So I have plans to design some color work. I really like color work and I want to dig more into it. And I have these bowl that my boyfriend offered me. He also got me a mug, and it's a traditional Romanian motif on it. It kind of looks like the Scandinavian colorwork tradition, as in it's, I'm sure specialists would spot the difference, but I don't. But it's definitely very different from Fair Isle. It's, from what I've seen, it's always a white background with red and black motifs, and it's embroidered on clothes. Yeah, so I wanted to design something with that motif because I really like it and I think it would look gorgeous as a knitwear, and especially a hat, because that's the, yeah, I guess that's the easiest thing to make a pattern as a first, because yeah, I've made patterns before, but it was really, really messy, and some people managed to follow it and to make beautiful things. It was a sweater, to make beautiful sweater out of it, and I don't know how they did it, but this time I want to make a proper nice pattern for a knitted hat with this motif. So I already sharted. Then I will put it on the computer, but I figured it was easier for me to draw it first. So this is one pattern repeat. And since it's mostly embroidered and I don't respect any traditions anyway, I am going to knit a Romanian embroidery motif with Icelandic wool. Why not, right? This is Let Loki, which works so well for color work. It's really nice. It's pure wool, and it's really, yeah, some people would say it's too scratchy, but I know it softens after being washed, and it works so well for color work. It's just perfect. So I have the white, I have, this is a black sheep, it's not dyed black, it's a black wool from a black sheep, which I usually prefer. It gives a more rough traditional look to it, and some red. So yeah, I am going to make a hat out of it with the Romanian motif. I hope it's gonna turn out okay. I'm so lucky with this because this is 30 stitches wide, so it works for 120 stitches, with for an adult hat in light DK would work, I figure. However, it's tall. It's a tall motif. And I guess computer-wise I could shrink it, but I figured I would just try to make like a hat with one wide motif of it, and like with a nice pompon and a nice rib to the brim, I think it would look okay. So I am going to cast this on and make my test and keep undoing and doing until I have something that looks nice, and then I can write it up as a pattern and share it if anybody is interested, like me, in knitting an embroidered Romanian pattern. It will look nice. It will look very nice. And yes, I am completely making a very wintry looking design in March. Maybe I will wait until at least autumn. But no, you should knit in the summer for the next winter. You totally should. So yeah, this is all the knitting plans. What have I left? Do you remember my crocheted hat? I was trying to make a Miss Coon pattern, the ebony hat by Miss Coon, and since I don't quite know how to crochet, it wasn't right. I don't know. I kind of knew it wasn't. I wasn't doing it good, but I didn't know. I didn't know what I was doing wrong, because as a knitter, I really enjoy not having to wonder where am I going to make the next stitch. But with crochet, it's not like that. I have to figure it out, how the stitch look and stuff. I didn't contact Miss Kim because my problem was not about not understanding the pattern. It was that I was a baby noob crocheter. So I didn't want to bother her with that, but I posted a picture on Instagram and she saw it and she wrote to me saying, oh, I think you're doing that. She was so nice. She sent me videos to help me out. Super nice person, Miss Gun, is really cool. Was really, really helpful because she immediately spotted what I was doing wrong. She said, you might be crocheting into the third loop. And yes, I mean, I didn't know why there were three loops, so I figured the back loop was the furthest, but no, this is the yarn over, and the stitch was the two at the front, so I was supposed to put my hook in the middle one. Now I finally understood, and I'm really glad that I did, because I was a bit discouraged with crocheting. How am I going to figure that out? But now I have, and I even finished it. It's still a bit wet because I blocked it and haven't let it dry. And now it actually looks kind of like how it's supposed to look. Yay! I finished it. It's finished. I made the pompon. And I'm just waiting for it to be dry to put the pom-pom on it. It fits. It's nice. I dyed my hair red, so maybe a red hat isn't the best idea now, but I don't care. I like that color, so I want it on my hair, on my hat, my clothes, everywhere. But yeah, I managed to do it, to follow a crochet pattern and it looking like it's supposed to look. I'm really happy about it, and it gives me hope again that someday I will be able to make like a crocheted crop top for the summer with cotton or something like that. It's nice, and I'm happy that I managed to do it. And thanks again to Miss Kun, who was really sweet about it. Super nice, and she immediately spotted what I was doing wrong, and yeah, that was sweet. So I believe I am done. I think it's going to be a little bit much of a shorter episode than usual, but yeah, maybe it's for the best, because I don't know if everybody likes to spend 2 hours watching podcasts. I've been obsessing over the Bakery Bears. I've heard about them from the Shock Mortician, and I finally decided to watch them, and I love them. They're amazing. Dan is the best person in the universe. Kay is super sweet, super gifted knitter, and I really like their show. I've been binge watching it all day long for the past 5 days. I've been watching only them because everybody went to the Edinburgh Yarn Festival, so nobody is posting podcasts. Please come back and make your yarn hauls and talk about this, because yeah, it's like I want to experience it like a greedy person, you know, that didn't get to do the nice thing. I'm gonna watch other people that have done it, and yeah, I can't wait to see what everybody has been up to. I guess that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed the sun. I hope you enjoyed the messy bed, yarn, curtain, with things hanging out of the wardrobe. Hope you enjoyed the cat, who's like curled up in a ball. Maybe I'm going to film it and add it at the end. I think I'm going to do that. Yeah, I hope I will see you next time with a little bit more consistent, crafty material. And yeah, have a lovely day, night, and week. And I'll see you soon. Bye bye. Hmm.